Alright, this is the video on transformations, point 5. Alright, and in this lesson we are learning about how to describe translations. So we've got our H and our K in vertex form. And H is going to describe left and right movements. Right, so H is going to describe either a right or a left. Okay? K is going to describe an up or a down. Let's make that green. So K is going to describe either an up or a down. So in our problems, the problems you have to do for homework or bookwork or for quiz or test is you're going to have to describe what the transformations are. So in problem number 1, we've got H is negative 2, okay? So H, that's the thing inside parentheses, is either a left or a right movement. We're always doing the opposite of H. So we have to think of the opposite direction as negative. So that would be, the opposite of negative would be to the right. So this is a translation. You have to use the word translation to the right, too. Okay? Now the K value is going to be your up or down translation. Right, so K is 3. So this is going to be, and it's also going to be translated up 3. All right, problem number 2. H is positive 3. K is negative 4. Okay, so the positive 3 is the left or the right. You're doing the opposite as the direction indicated. So we are going to go to the left, and again, you have to use the word translation. This is a translation to the left 3. And it is a translation, K is going to be a vertical movement, either up or down. We're not taking the opposite of that one, so it is down 4. All right, so now putting it all together. All right, so in a previous video, we learned about reflections and dilations. That all has to do with A. So if your A value is negative, that's a reflection across the x-axis. It is negative, so the first thing I'm going to say is this is a reflection across the x-axis. All right, now, if A, the absolute value of A is less than 1, that would be a compression. And if the absolute value of A is greater than 1, it's a stretch. All right, so in this case, the absolute value of A is 1. So that means we're neither compressing or stretching. We are translating, however. So I've got H is negative 5. So negative 5, the H always goes in the opposite direction indicated, H is left or right. So here I'm going, it's a translation to the right 5, and then K is the vertical movement, either up or down. You keep the same as the indicated sign, so this is going to be up 6. All right, for problem number 4, A is 2. not negative. That means there is no reflection. Its absolute value of 2 is greater than 1, so that makes it a stretch. So it is a stretch of factor 2. I wouldn't necessarily expect you to write factor 2, but I want you to be used to seeing that terminology. Now the H and the K are the translations. So H, okay, that is a positive, so it is moving to the left. So this is a translation to the left, 7. And then K is the up or down movement, and so we're going to say down, H. All right, and then problem number 5. A equals 1/2. It is not negative, so it's not a reflection. The absolute value of A, 1/2, is less than 1. That's what makes it a compression. So this is a compression of factor 1/2. Okay. The translation, notice there's nothing inside parentheses. All right, so that means there is no H. It is not moving left and it's not moving right. It does have a K, so that's the up or down. So this is a translation. It's positive, up 9. All right, practice the bookwork on this.